Who else would be better suited to handle such sensitive things as official documents than banks? They've positioned themselves as trustworthy institutions for centuries and could leverage this to become digital record keepers. Admittedly, this is quite a leap from where we are today, but it is possible. Banks have not only the right positioning, but also experience in complying with complex regulations and could be trusted with such a sensible task by governments. There are plenty of potential new markets. In such a situation, the explicit suggestion of Blue Ocean Theory and the implicit message of Porter's Five Forces model is to exit unattractive markets. Yet will the drop in attractiveness really justify leaving the huge retail banking business? You might have guessed it. The answer is no. Citi GPS in 2016 estimates that the biggest chunk, 46%, of all global banking profit is made with personal and small to medium enterprise, SME, banking. It's hard to imagine how a technology, no matter how revolutionary, could cancel out these profits. Besides, banks' heft, scale, and their societal importance are based on retail banking. But staying in retail banking is not just a matter of the big fat line at the bottom of the balance sheet, but also of achieving long-term revenue with new services. Today's customers of financial services are tomorrow's users of verifications or secured communication. If banks shift their focus away from their core business, they will most certainly lose out on the next big thing enabled by the blockchain: smart contracts. Furthermore, states would try to block exits, and those actors attempting to exit might fall into disfavour with regulators. Former customers would be allocated to competitors, resulting in scale advantages that might well transcend the retail segment.